My name is Michael Batista, and I'm a product manager here at Equinix. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the new functionality called Quick Connect that was released in Fabric 2023.1. Equinix Fabric currently provides our customers with the ability to create Layer 2 connections to Google Cloud Partner Interconnect. In order to create this connection, customers must first configure a Google Partner Interconnect VLAN attachment in the GCP portal. The customer must then log into the Fabric portal to create the connection. In this release, we're enhancing the Fabric portal by giving our customers the option to create a VLAN attachment within the Fabric portal itself as part of the Create Connection workflow. I'll go ahead and log into the Fabric portal to walk through creating a connection to GCP with Quick Connect. After logging in, I'll select Create Connection and scroll down to the Frequent Connection section. Here, a new option, Quick Connect, is available to connect to GCP. To create a connection to GCP, we need a Google Cloud VLAN attachment. Here, there are two options. The first option is to create the connection using an existing Google Cloud VLAN attachment and parent key that was created in the GCP portal. The second option is to sign in with your Google credentials in the Fabric portal, which allows you to create a new Google Cloud VLAN attachment to use for a connection. In this demo, I'll sign in with my GCP account. To sign in with your GCP account, you must ensure you have a valid Google Cloud account to access Google Cloud connections, a dedicated router in your Google Cloud account to create a connection, and Compute API enabled in an existing project. Also, be sure to allow pop-ups on your browser and to not use a private or incognito window. Now, I'll go ahead and sign in with my GCP account. When creating the Google Cloud VLAN attachment, you can choose a single VLAN or redundant VLAN. For this demo, I'll choose redundant VLAN. I'll go ahead and select the project, network, and region. For VLAN A, I'll select the cloud router, enter the VLAN attachment. The description is optional, and the maximum transmission unit is pre-selected to 1440. I'll then configure VLAN B. Note that VLAN pre-activation is enabled by default with Quick Connect. We can now move on to the Equinix configuration. For this demo, I'll choose port as the origin asset type, and Silicon Valley as the on-ramp location to Google Cloud. For the primary connection, I'll go ahead and select a port. After selecting the port, you can view details like cable ID, location, priority, encapsulation, bandwidth, the billing account associated with the port, and average latency. I'll go ahead and enter the connection name and select the bandwidth, where we can see the price next to the speed. We'll then go ahead and enter the VLAN ID. For the secondary connection, we'll go ahead and select a port. You'll notice that bandwidth for the secondary connection is pre-selected based on the bandwidth of the primary connection. If you change the bandwidth of the primary connection, it also changes the bandwidth for the secondary. I'll go ahead and enter the connection name and the VLAN ID. And now we can move on to configuring the contact information. You'll notice that the email of the logged in user is pre-populated, and you can add 11 more email addresses that will receive notifications related to the status of the connection. For this demo, I'll skip the optional purchase order number and purchase reference ID. And after reviewing and accepting the Equinix Quick Connect order terms and conditions, the Create Connection button is enabled. We'll go ahead and submit the connection. After submitting the connection, you can view it in the Fabric inventory or the Google Cloud inventory. We'll take a look in the Fabric inventory. Here we can see both of our connections, both in the provisioning state. After some time, they'll both switch to the provisioned state. Now the connections are both provisioned, and we'll take a look at the details. That concludes this demo. Thanks for watching.